this video, we will see the gland system for STG. So first I will explain the parameters of this page. This is the HP steam line. We are getting the steam temperature as 530, steam pressure as 90 and steam flow 110 TPH. These are the two emergency shutoff valves for HP steam. Second one is IP injection steam. This is the emergency shutoff valve for IP injection steam. The live temperature of IP steam is 267 and pressure is 3 kg. And we are getting the steam flow as 15 tons per hour. This is the upper casing and this is the lower casing temperature of steam turbine. This is the chest pressure. This part is vacuum and these are the three vacuum switches. This is the hood spray USB used to cool the exhaust hood if the temperature goes above 55 or 60 degrees Celsius. The exhaust of steam turbine is connected with the air cooled condenser duct. These are the two gland steam vapor condenser fans. And now to avoid the steam leakage of HP steam turbine into the front bearing and not to ingress the air in the LP stages of the turbine, the gland sealing steam is usually provided in the labyrinth seal of steam turbine. So this is the steam supply for gland seal. It is the tapping for this steam is taken from auxiliary steam supply. This is the common header made for the utility purpose. This is the MOV used to isolate the steam in case of emergency. This is the control valve used to regulate the pressure of the gland sealing steam. Currently it is reading 0.039. The temperature of the steam is 251 degrees Celsius. Now this steam is going in the labyrinth seal. This is the front bearing of the steam turbine and this is the rear bearing of the steam turbine. So this gland sealing steam is entering in the labyrinth seal at front bearing side and one at rear bearing side. Now when this steam travels through the labyrinth seal, it escapes and enter into the gland steam vent condenser. There is a common header where steam from the HP side and steam from the LP side merge together and pulls to the atmosphere through these blowers. Now we are utilizing this waste steam to heat the CEP water. So the temperature of the water coming from the CEP is heated and steam gets cool and this water is used for utility purpose. In this way we provide the sealing in the steam turbine.